How are you doing this morning? My name is Matthew Wright. I'm a spiritual teacher here in Richmond, and intuitive and an empath, and a medium too.
My name is Jeremy Elliott. I'm also from Richmond, Virginia. I am a spiritual teacher, a psychic, a medium, and a clairvoyant.
And just a few words before we start. It feels like to just clarify this, you know, that we do a lot of different various work with helping people understand life and death and the truth behind death and life, you know, as well as other spiritual teachings that we struck. But we have people come from the physical side here asking for help, contacting the spirit side. And, you know, like I said, we don't charge anybody anything, never have, never will. We just do it to help. But we also, I want to say, we have this side, like this, you know, the spirit world and whatnot. Sometimes comes to us. They find us a lot of the time, since we're open, you know.
Right.
Basically, we're open for business. You can put it that way.
Yeah.
You know, they know when somebody can see them. So we just like to film these videos and put the message out there that they want to put out. So this dude, D, has been coming through, like, for the past week or so, really, you know. Something like that, a few days or whatever. He's got some, I think he needs to speak some stuff. There's some stuff on your mind. I feel that, brother.
Well, he just said, hey, you know, hey. He doesn't really know what to talk about, you know.
Well, I guess the object here, man, is to heal pain left on this side. Isn't that what I'm feeling?
Well, he doesn't want the grief on this side to keep on going, you know. He wants the grief of his family and his friends to cease along with him, you know.
Describe what he looks like. Do that.
Well, he's got like a hat on, and he's light skinned. It looks like he's got like some kind of white shirt on that has something on it, and some baggy jeans, you know.
Yeah. See, one thing to consider though, that like, you know, people, like, you know, spirits know your thoughts and your emotion, and they. I like to say it speaks to them like words, but so they, every time you think about them, there they are, you know what I'm saying? There's not, there's any delay them noticing it, you know what I'm saying? They notice.
But he's very saying a lot about the grief thing.
That's what we're trying to talk about,
yeah.
You know, like it's dragging him down in a way. It's
yeah.
Hard on him to remember that, you know, as far as this brother here, it's hard on all of them.
Very much so.
You know. I think he just wants to understand that, look, it's all right, you know. He is, looks like he's adjusted, you know.
Yeah, he's adjusted.
Adjusted.
Well adjusted, yeah. He doesn't want the families and friends involved with his death to continuously grieve because it's heavy on him, you know. That's what he's saying most importantly. Otherwise, he's kind of quiet, you know,
yeah.
And reserved, kind of doing his head like this, you know. You like that, you know.
But it's important that you do this, brother. It's going to help you and help them. So, and that's the point of it. But it's like, the grief is a heavy drag down in this situation.
Yeah.
I feel that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Heavy. Heavy drag down. So.
Yeah, he wishes he could just be able to tell all his family, you know, like, just relax. You know, he's all right. You know, he likes where he's at, you know. Where he's at is happiness, you know. It's all happiness.
It's not like this world with all this suffering and money problems and worry and anxiety and hatred. It's,
nah.
That's why he's happy. It's not there like that, you
right.
know. Yeah, this is not there in the spirit world, you know. So, I mean, look, people are just as alive there as they are here.
Yeah,
it just looks a little different.
He's like, that's what I want him to know. That's all I want him to know. Don't be worried.
Yeah, that's what I was feeling. And you'll catch up with him one day when, you know, due time, you know, when y'all finish your lives and your work here and cross over. Hey, he'll be there, you know, catch up with him, you know. But he just wants y'all to, like, to let go.
Grief is the Buddha came to. The grief is considered another word for love. You know, that's what he said.
Buddha.
Yeah.
Sometimes Lord Buddha comes through and assists us with this.
Yeah.
And assists spirits too.
basically saying that love and grief are two indescribable things, but they value each other, you know.
Well, a person wouldn't be grieving over somebody if they didn't love them.
Right.
And then if you don't love somebody, you wouldn't grieve, you
right.
know.
Right.
Is that correct, Lord Buddha? That's what you're trying to say.
So, what Dee is saying is love instead of grieve, you know.
Good idea, yeah.
That's what he wants, love, no grief.
Just be like, let me say this, why not throw a party for him? And that's what I told other people, this party for him, you know. Like, do something, go out and pick a drink up for him or something, or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, like, I see, like, someone smoke or something. They smoke some weed or something, you know, or whatever, you know.
Do
what you do, you know. I mean,
show compassion, you know.
That's right.
Life, you know.
Yeah, I mean, like, things happen in this world. People forget who they really are as the eternal spirits. People act out, do crazy shit.
He was laughing when we said that thing about the drinking and the weed.
Yeah, that's what we do, D, man. Lift it up, like, you know, your people are like, yeah, smoke one, the D, let's smoke one, you know? Like, you know, and then that would help him, you know? Not necessarily smoking weed, but laughing and smiling. And being happy for him.
Yeah, having a party inside, you know.
Inside yourself.
Yeah.
You can't outwardly have a party and then inside, he's not here, and then I'm being sad. Mm-hmm. And that's not a real, it has to be in your heart, you know. Party could be within yourself, or it could be physically manifested.
But when Dee put his fist out like this, and then he's back in that way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, brother, all right, brother, you know.
He's like walking away like he's a cowboy or something.
Yeah. I like the fist thing, yeah. All right, brother, we'll get this, you know, we'll take care of it. But look, you know, that's seriously, though, I know it's hard to break through this grief and all of this, you know, but I don't know, you know, me and Jeremy, when we, you know, we hear people die, there's no getting upset, no crying, none of this grief, you know. In fact, we're happy. Very happy for the people that died, you know. That's what it's hard for people to understand in this world.
Yeah,
you know?
Very hard.
Like, you should be jumping up and down for joy, you know.
Yeah, it should be more of a celebrated, you know, because we were born to die. So we're graduating, you know.
And then, like, something Jeremy said the other week for another video for someone else about that. Didn't you say something about that every minute, like, we're, quote, 1 second closer to death?
Yeah.
The Buddha said that anyway.
We're heading towards the light, you know. That's what it is. We're moving towards the light, you know. There's nothing that can change that except for moving towards the light. Yeah. That's all we can do.
That's it. I mean, like, born to die. And we die to be born. That's